Hey guys!
Alright guys, we're here today to check out two videos. It's a Doubleheader Monday, as always. The special note about this Doubleheader Monday is that there is no Patreon request. Both bands reach out to us, both bands ask us to check out their videos, and we're starting off, by the way, both bands are from two lovely nations. Two wonderful, hockey-loving, moose-fucking nations. Two, well, maybe one more moose-fucking than the other.
Two nations but, that are known as the Lands of Snow and Sorrow.
Yes, both nations known for having winter, sons of winter and stars. Absolutely. We're starting off with the one closest to us, which is Canada, Toronto. This band is from Toronto. Astaroth Incarnate. I saw these guys open for Wolfheart when they were doing the Beaverheart tour. All right, so this is an extreme metal band from Toronto. I would say that's pretty much where you can set your aim at. Extreme metal band from Toronto. Having said that, they're kind of changing their sound a little bit going into. They have a new EP coming out in December, December 6th. And I've talked to Sam, he's the lead singer, and they've made some changes to the band. So the sound perhaps won't be the same as what I'm used to it from when I saw them live back on that Wolfheart tour. Okay. But that's what makes this exciting, because this is their brand new video, latest video, and this song is on that brand new EP that comes out December 6th. All right? Okay. Did I set the story for you? All right, so Astaroth Incarnate, extreme metal band from Toronto. You ready for this?
Yeah.
All right, let's do this. Thank you. All right. I forgot to say the name of the song. I am fire. I am death. What did you think? That was, I think it's their first time listening to this band. Obviously, yeah. You were not at that show that I went
so
to.
Is this close to what was at the show?
No, more symphonic.
More symphonic.
So when I saw them live, they didn't have this much of a symphonic element to their sound. It was more the extreme part of metal, but not as much with the symphonic.
Yeah.
Okay, so what's your take?
But it had a lot of kind of black metal to it a little bit, but it wasn't bad. The only part I kind of didn't like as much was the part near the end where it kind of became like the guttural vocals.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only thing I didn't like. Other than that, it was really, really good.
Okay, so let's break it down. Like I said, when I saw them, they didn't have as much of a symphonic element. How did you feel about the symphonic? Because this song has it's very symphonic in nature. The bass line of the track,
yeah.
There's a symphonic bass line to this track. How do you feel like that incorporates with the more extreme sound that they have? Do you feel like those go well together?
It goes well together. It fits perfectly together because it kind of has, you know, the symphonic element. To me, it has a little bit of black metal in it, and it goes well together. The only part I just didn't like was the little girl.
Okay, so I'm gonna say this. I'm not a huge fan of those like almost squealing.
Which it did become.
There was a few.
It was only the one part near the end.
So there's certain. I'm not a huge fan of that style of vocal, that specific style of vocals. Having said that, I'll say this. This to me is a move for the band. I saw them before that they had this symphonic sound. To me, this is a move for me, in my opinion, is a move in the right direction. I feel the symphonic sound fits their style really well. The symphonic allows the song to still be dark. It still allows them to be extreme. It still allows the song to be heavy, but it adds a little bit of a sinister vibe to the track. That's my opinion.
Yeah.
Now, that sinister vibe works well, and now I'm going to go into the vocals. To me, this was almost the extreme metal version of like King Diamond. You know, like when you listen to King Diamond, he changes his vocal approach depending on who the character of the story is, depending on what's happening within the lyrics of the song. You know what I mean? Like he changes his vocal approach. And I've always been a fan of that you using your vocal range in order to tell the story of the lyrics, in order to enhance the whole experience, right? This song does that because he changes... Sam changes his vocal delivery like three, four different styles throughout the song. And that to me, for as much as I'm not a fan of certain pieces within that vocal range, I'm not a big fan of those. Having said that, I am a fan when it's put all together from a perspective of telling a story and from a perspective of a more almost of a dark, like almost like a horror movie dark setting to it, right? So if you think about the way this song plays out with the music, the extreme side of the track, I'm not talking about the symphonic stuff. I'm talking about, by the way, the guitar solo was absolutely magnificent. Oh. Before I forget, I gotta say that guitar solo was really good. So when you put together how, like, there's certain parts there when it gets into the chorus with how heavy the drums are. I really love the vocals on the chorus. Because it adds, the vocals on the chorus are not as heavy as they are on the verses, but the drums are heavy. So yeah. The two kind of balance each other out. So when you look at the music and you look at the changes that he's doing within his vocal range as the story of the song is going along, I like that aspect. Now, if it didn't have the symphonic elements, I think it would fall flat. Because with the symphonic elements added into the track, it gives it almost like a 70s horror movie cinematic vibe to the track.
I can't imagine this band now without that symphonic stuff. Well,
it's really extreme.
Especially this song in general, because this song needs some.
I agree with you, and I'm glad.
The piano and everything kind of makes the song.
It gives an atmosphere.
If you don't have that, it just becomes.
It was almost like, you know, you don't remember this, but in horror movies, black and white vampire horror movies, Obviously, the like back in the day when they didn't talk, when there were the movies, like there was no audio, they would use like these things that would come up with the words that they were saying to each other in between scenes. And there was always this like really dark soundtrack in the background. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Like a piano, really dark piano soundtrack in the background. So they did that, but with vocals. Do you see what I'm saying? So I really like the fact that these guys were not afraid to say, okay, this is who we are. But I really think if we add some symphonic elements to our sound, we can really elevate what we're doing. We can give more presence. We can give more volume to the songs. Because I've seen them live. They're very theatrical in their stage show. When you go see them live, it's almost like you're watching a play, right? Like there's a whole stage show. There's like a feel of a play. Like I said, very reminiscent of King Diamond from that perspective, right? So when you have that, now you add the symphonic elements. You add this cinematic, almost black and white, you know, like Charlie Chaplin, but like, you know, like old school Dracula horror movies, you know, like Nosferatu, that kind of stuff. You adding that to the mix. Then when you add Sam's vocals and his range and how he can change,
it
goes perfect. For as much, like I said at the beginning, I'm not necessarily a fan of that specific, certain styles of those vocals. In this setting,
it kind
of
works.
It works. In this setting, it works.
It still works. I just don't prefer those vocals.
Okay, but I just feel that in order for you to get engulfed into the character of the story, like the lyrics, the vocals need to, there has to be a drastic change within the vocals in order to set very drastic. Yeah. So you have to have that in order to create the nuances that the song needs. I like it in this setting. Outside of this setting, I'm not necessarily a fan. But when you look at the whole picture of the whole, the song is together. When you look at the symphonic element, that keyboard is so dark. It's so haunting. Magnificent. I really like
it. It's kind of a key part of the song.
Absolutely. Without the symphonic elements, the song does not have the same feel.
The song kind of, it just becomes this big, heavy kind of thing.
Without the symphonic elements, it's just a really heavy track.
It's just a really, really heavy track. I would still kind of be a fan of it, but the vocals, the guttural vocals wouldn't have made as much sense.
Yeah, I to me, they make more sense in the setting that they're in because, like I said, there's a little bit of a cinematic feel to it.
Because of the
keyboard and all the symphonic elements that the track has. You take those away and then the song is just not the same. Then to me, the song, then it needs, you know, the way the drums are heavy in the chorus, then it needed that kind of heaviness, but even in the verses, it just needed to be a little bit extra heavier.
Yeah.
When you add the symphonic elements, you can allow yourself to not necessarily be heavy from the first minute to the last minute because the symphonic elements kind of push the song, push the boundaries of the track and give the track more volume, make the song feel like more cinematic, gives a larger stage. It almost becomes theatrical, right? And that to me is perfect. Theatrical is the perfect word because the band live is very theatrical. So to me, the symphonic elements add to that theater scene and then you have him playing different characters with his vocal range. That to me, when you put it in this setting, I like it. But like I said, I'm not a fan of certain styles within that range on their own.
Yeah.
But in this setting, I'm okay with it, you know. All right. Now that we said that, don't go anywhere. There's another video coming right after.
Yeah.
It's a band from Finland. Okay, we'll break the ice. There's a band from Finland coming.
I feel like we gave a lot of hints.
Yeah, we did. Also a band that we've never done on the channel. And they reach out to us. So, all right, guys. Don't go anywhere. There's another video coming right after. See you guys.
See ya.